So hi, Microbe Hunter here again, and today I'm going to show you another rather strange ciliate, a rather strange microorganism, one that I recently found again in one of my water samples. And as a matter of fact, I think that it might actually be really broken. It might be actually defective. I've never seen any microorganism or any ciliate like this before. It's very irregular and also its movement was rather chaotic, I have to admit. In any case, I was wondering why in the world does it have this shape? And of course, I don't know the answer. I'm assuming that there might be a problem or might have been a problem during cell division. Maybe there was something going on which was not quite right, and then maybe the cell divided somewhat asymmetrically and the cell was still able to survive somehow. I was wondering now, what is it actually that gives cells their shape? And I of course did a little bit of research, and we of course all know that on the outside of a cell there is a plasma membrane or a cell membrane, but this cell membrane really is not very strong. It's quite flexible. It does control what goes into the cell and what goes out of the cell, but it itself in most cases is not really very stable and very rigid. And what there are, however, is a so-called cytoskeleton. And this cytoskeleton are protein fibers that hold the cell together from the inside. And I think that maybe in this case, there might be something wrong with the cell's cytoskeleton, because after all, this is the thing, these are the structures that provide the cell with a shape. And as a matter of fact, I did a little bit more research and discovered that already back in the year 1903, so over 100 years ago, a Russian scientist, and his name was Nikolai Koltsov, and he already proposed that there must be something like a cytoskeleton. And he was actually also the person who named the cytoskeleton, who gave it its name. And this is for me quite a remarkable thing, because the cytoskeleton actually is not so easy to see. With fluorescent microscopy and with fluorescent labeling, it is possible to see the cytoskeleton, but these techniques were only developed back in the 1940s, so much later than when Koltsov actually made his prediction. So in that sense, yeah, we're left guessing why in the world this little critter has the shape that it has. Evidently, it is able to survive, obviously, otherwise it's not able, I wouldn't have been able to see it under the microscope. But I think that indeed something must have gone wrong here. And I think that is now a new project that I have. Now, from now on, I'm going to start looking for microorganisms that look a little bit different than others, because maybe there is something wrong with them. Well, I hope it was interesting for you. I know that the video quality in this video was not the very highest. The little critter was floating in and out of focus all the time. But in any case, I hope it was interesting nevertheless. Happy microbe hunting as always. See you around next time, and bye-bye.